Starship Flight 4 is almost near, but are we rushing towards the launch? Today's Falcon 9 midnight launch. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello, everyone. It's great to be back with the SpaceX community. It's been a while since our last video, and I'm thrilled to return. I've been tied up with other projects, which took me away from YouTube for a bit. I know there has been a lot happening in the space industry, and I'm sorry for missing some of it. But let's get back on track. Today's video is all about the latest updates on SpaceX's Starship. Exciting news! SpaceX has finally static-fired Ship 30. But before we jump into that, let's go through our usual timeline updates. 2 days ago, SpaceX's Starship S30 faced some problems during the static fire test, causing a delay. Even though they were well prepared and tried multiple times, the test didn't go as planned. The first attempt showed there might be a problem with the fuel pipe during the fuel loading process, but SpaceX quickly sorted out and tried again later in the day. During the second try, things looked much better as the fuel seemed to load fully. However, the static fire didn't happen as expected. Venting throughout the ship and the detanking showed that the test didn't go as planned. Despite these issues, SpaceX didn't give an official explanation for what happened. Yesterday, SpaceX successfully did the static fire test for Starship S30. After the initial problems, the team probably did a lot of testing and troubleshooting to fix any issues. Yesterday morning, SpaceX warned residents about the scheduled static fire. Around 11 a.m., they started loading fuel, and frost lines showed that fuel was present. Then, around 11:30, they started the engine chill process, with venting at the leg of the test stand, showing that they were getting ready to activate the engine. Finally, around 11:58, Ship 30 fired its engines for about 8 seconds. SpaceX later confirmed that it was a 6-engine static fire test. The successful test shows that SpaceX was able to fix the problems from first attempt. The static fire test is a big step in getting ready for Flight 5, and finishing it shows progress in SpaceX's big plans for Starship development. Even though the first try may have caused some delays, yesterday's successful test shows SpaceX's ability to bounce back and adapt in the transformative world of rocket development. Besides the work on S30, the launch system has been busy with the OLM and launch tower going through a strong venting process that covers the whole launch site area, including the test stand area. This step of the launch site area is important to get ready for upcoming activities. One of these activities is the expected appearance of Flight 4 hardware, S29 and B11. Right now, they're at the production site, and SpaceX plans to launch Flight 4 later this month. You know, now we are at almost second week of May, and there are 3 more weeks left. I think they will conclude with all the remaining procedures within the second last week, probably leaving the wet dress rehearsal, as it is something that is conducted almost close to the launch date. Anyways, one thing is sure, they have to ramp up everything within the remaining days in order for a May last week launch. Now, coming onto the production site, let's talk about the S26 prototype as it has been getting some eyes last week. At first, it was moved from the Rocket Garden to Mega Bay 2, and I thought it might get scrapped, but SpaceX surprised me. Yes, they just rolled out a big ship stand from the Massey test site to Mega Bay 2 yesterday morning. I think this stand looked much futuristic and minimalistic comparing the older ones, isn't it? And by the afternoon, S26 was lifted onto this stand, and by midnight, SpaceX started moving the prototype to the Masseys for more test campaigns. So now you may be wondering whether they are going to test Ship 26 is going to undergo testing on this new stand with flame trench system? Of course. First of all, SpaceX made this system to bring the testing process into one area, instead of doing it at the launch site. Since S29 is planned for Flight 4 and S30, S31, and S32 are reserved for future flights, none of these prototypes can be used to test the new system. Even though S20 is also at Starbase, it hasn't been active for a long time, making S26 a better choice. At the production site, another big development is happening, marked by a new section arriving on the way to Mega Bay 2. This isn't just any section, it's made up of 3 rings that have been welded together. What could this be for? Well, considering that B14 is almost done with the stack, it's highly likely that this section is for the new version of Starship. Yes, you heard it right. We're all excitedly waiting for the next update from SpaceX, and we're hoping that this is the beginning of Starship version 2. This aligns perfectly with Musk's goal of producing 6 prototypes this year. Anyway, let's hope for the best, and stay tuned for more SpaceX Starship updates. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. SpaceX sent 20 more Starlink satellites into space from California early Friday morning. This launch, which took place at Vandenberg Space Force Base, featured 13 satellites designed to provide direct-to-cell capability. Originally scheduled for Wednesday night, the mission faced a delay before successfully lifting off on Friday at 12:30 a.m. EDT. The Falcon 9 rocket, carrying the Starlink craft, embarked on its journey, aiming to enhance internet connectivity globally. Following liftoff, the Falcon 9's first stage executed a planned return to Earth. About 8 minutes post-launch, it made a controlled landing on the SpaceX drone ship named Of Course I Still Love You, stationed in the Pacific Ocean. Impressively, this marked the 4th successful launch and landing for this particular first stage, underscoring SpaceX's strides in reusability, a key aspect of their cost-effective approach to spaceflight. Meanwhile, the Falcon 9's upper stage continued its journey, ferrying the Starlink satellites to their intended destination, Low Earth Orbit, LEO. Approximately 61.5 minutes after liftoff, the satellites were deployed, positioning them to begin their mission of expanding internet coverage across the globe. This recent launch adds to SpaceX's growing constellation of Starlink satellites, aimed at providing high-speed internet access to underserved areas and improving connectivity worldwide. Notably, just days before this launch, SpaceX successfully launched 23 Starlink satellites from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. This rapid succession of launches demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to advancing their satellite internet project and accelerating the deployment of their constellation. SpaceX's ability to conduct back-to-back launches is becoming increasingly common, showcasing their operational efficiency and capacity for frequent access to space. In March, for instance, SpaceX achieved a notable milestone by launching 2 missions within a span of less than 4 hours. This included a Starlink mission and the deployment of the Eutelsat 36D telecommunications satellite, both launched from Florida's Space Coast. The frequency and success of SpaceX's launches underscore their position as a leading player in the space industry. Through their ambitious Starlink project and innovative approach to space transportation, SpaceX continues to push the boundaries of what's possible in space exploration and satellite technology. With each successful launch, they inch closer to their goal of revolutionizing global internet accessibility and advancing humanity's presence in space. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.